Can you imagine the horror if we ran out of IP addresses? Well, here's the kicker. We have. But there's a solution. It's called IPv6. What is it? How does it compare to the previous version? Let's find out. First up, the basics. What's an IP address? Every device that connects to the internet is given an internet protocol address, aka IP address. It's a combination of numbers issued by your internet service provider, like a passport or an ID card. When I use the internet, then the system needs to know who you are. These addresses originally came from something called IPv4. Now, a quick history lesson. IPv4, as in Internet Protocol version 4, was created in the 80s. It used a 32-bit numeric address scheme to store around 4 billion IP addresses. When it was first made, it seemed like it'd supply all the addresses we would ever need. Yet, popularity and accessibility of the internet grew, and boom, version 4 was not enough. Then, Internet Protocol version 6 swooped in and saved the day. It was created in the 90s and uses a much bigger 128-bit alphanumeric address scheme. This means that IPv6 can store, wait for it, 340 undecillion IP addresses. That's a trillion, trillion, trillion. So IPv6 can hold 1,028 times more addresses than IPv4. But it's not just the amount of storage that's important. V6 has also addressed many of V4's shortcomings, including security issues. For example, IPsec is a set of protocols that helps to keep our online communication secure, authentic, and free from tampering. It's built into IPv6, but if you're using IPv4, you'll need to add IPsec separately. Why does this matter? Well, when we send information over the internet, we want to make sure it stays private and that no one can change it along the way. IPsec helps us do that by encrypting our data and verifying that it's coming from the right source. But not all internet service providers use IPsec for IPv4 addresses. IPv6 is also designed for end-to-end encryption, making man-in-the-middle attacks much, much more unlikely. And when it comes to name resolution, IPv6 adds an extension to Neighbor Discovery Protocol to make it way more secure. Plus, IPv6 provides two security headers that can be used together or separately: the authentication header and encapsulating security payload. These provide message authentication, protect against replay attacks, and give privacy and confidentiality by encrypting the payload. But the perks don't end with security. IPv6 has brought much more functionality, such as multicast addressing. This allows bandwidth-intensive packet flows to be sent simultaneously, which basically reduces network bandwidth. IPv6 also has a new auto-configuration feature, which allows a device to generate an IP address. As soon as it connects to a network, the device will look for an IPv6 router and create its own local and global address. With V4, this has to be done manually. V6 also allows much better configuration capabilities, allowing devices to stay connected to multiple networks at the same time. Yep, no secret, IPv6 sounds great. But, you see, most of us are still using IPv4 IPs. Why? Well, changing everything over to IPv6 takes a while. Don't forget that V4 has been around for so long that it makes up over 90% of internet traffic. Plus, sticking with V4 is cheaper and more efficient. It's been tried and tested for some time, while the V6 is still relatively new. It's the future of the internet for sure, but too many devices don't support it. They say Rome wasn't built in a day, and that was just one city. So if you want to convert the entire planet's IP addresses, well, you're gonna need a couple of days. Now, what about these different versions and VPNs or proxies? First up, you might already have IPv4 and IPv6. It all depends on your internet service provider. Some give their users both, while others don't. So if you've got IPv6, can you still use VPNs and proxies? The answer is no. Not really. Most VPNs don't support IPv6. So if you have both versions active, your VPN will mask version 4, but version 6 will go unblocked. A scary thought, right? In such a case, your VPN is useless, because your location will be exposed by version 6. Your best option is immediately to turn off version 6 in your system's network settings. Then check if your VPN has a service called IPv6 leak protection that you can activate. Or play it ultra safe and get a VPN that definitely works with version 6. And what about proxies? Well, same thing. It depends on the service provider. At Smartproxy, we're proud to say that we support both IPv4 and IPv6. So check us out if you fancy access to the fastest proxies in the market. Oh, and one more thing to know, most websites, they don't even support IPv6 yet. So you'll need to disable it if you want to do some scraping, cop sneakers, or automate your social media business. Even if your proxy supports IPv6, you won't get a lot out of it just yet. So we've got V4 versus V6. Who's the winner? Even though both versions have neat features, IPv4 wins just because most devices operate on it, and there's been a ton of work to improve it and keep it up to date. Having said that, IPv4's days are numbered. We're officially out of IPs, so the change to IPv6 will ramp up, especially with its security improvements. There's an IPv6 sunrise on the horizon, and it's getting closer.